Good morning, church family. It is Friday, April the 24th, and early on April the 24th, we just want to let you know that as a church, we supported our local hospital, Baptist Nassau, and brought them some Chick-fil-A biscuits this morning. So thank you for Chick-fil-A for opening up a little bit earlier, and then also thank you to all our healthcare workers at Baptist Nassau for all you guys are doing. I hope you enjoy those chicken biscuits. So just wanted to come to you this morning and just share a word of encouragement. Today's devotion comes out of Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 46. And we're actually just going to take that verse. And I'm just going to read the verse of what it's about, not really give you the kind of background of what Jeremiah is writing to, because it's talking, you know, with Babylonians and stuff like that. But the verse itself kind of really hits home to where we are today in the essence of what it says. And I just want to read it, and then we'll get into our devotion and to the truth of who God is and who Jesus is today. So Jeremiah 51 verse 46 says, "Do not lose heart or be afraid." So do not lose heart or be afraid. Now listen to this next part. "When rumors are heard in the land, one rumor comes this year and another the next." And so for the last little bit of, at the end of the devotions that I've been doing, I always tell you guys and always encourage you guys to turn down the volume of the media and turn up the truth of God's word. And this verse really says that, because if we listen to the media, and don't get me wrong, I love to watch the media. I love to listen to what's going on. I'd like to know what's going on in the world. I like to know what's going on in our community. I like to know what's going on in Jacksonville. So it's not one of those things where I'm telling you not to listen to them. But the truth of the matter is sometimes, and this isn't a conspiracy theory that I'm about to say, so please don't get that idea. Sometimes we just don't know what is truth and what is not truth. And it seems like whenever you're watching some of the media, you get one angle and then you get another angle, and then it just seems to be so diluted sometimes. And I think in this season in our life, I think we need to watch it to keep up with what's going on and, you know, and to see what's happening. But don't let what is said, the rumors, as it says in this verse, don't let it make you lose heart, because that's what it does. What we need to do is we need to get into the truth of God's word. And here's the truth. Here's the underlying principle for today, is that God is truth. Jesus said it himself. He said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." And so what I want to encourage you guys to do is, like I said, every one of these things, you know, turn down the volume of the media, turn up the truth of God's word, because not just because of possible rumors or not getting the, you know, just because the truth is what we need to fill our hearts with. And the truth is God's word. Jesus is the truth. God is the truth. And so I just pray that today, as you're going about today, that if you hear something or from wherever, Facebook, social media, the TV, wherever you hear it from, just listen to it and just be like, okay. But rely, lean into, stand on the truth of God, because He is the truth. He is the way. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." And my prayer is that today you're able to stand on the truth of God's word and who He is and the truth of Christ. I love you guys. I'm praying for you guys. So let's pray. God, there's so much stuff bombarding us every day, Lord. And And truthfully, God, it's okay for us to, and I get this, it's okay for us to watch the media and to know what's happening in the world, know what's happening in Jacksonville, know what's happening in our little community here in Fernandina. But God, my prayer is that all of that stuff, when it gets into our hearts or gets into our minds, God, that it doesn't affect us and we don't lose heart and that we don't become afraid. And God, that we don't lose heart because we are standing on the truth of God's word. We are standing on the fact that Jesus is the truth. And we are relying on that and we are believing in that, Father. So I'm praying for us today, God. I pray, God, that we don't lose heart. Maybe we'll hear something, God, that we don't lose heart. Maybe the day of will be pushed further out, that we have to go back, or the stay-at-home order will be further out. I don't know, Lord, but that doesn't matter, because what matters is that we're standing on your truth. And the fact that you said that you would never leave us nor forsake us. God, we're standing on your truth of who you are. God, we are standing and relying and believing in the truth of our living Savior. So God, I just pray for us. God, give us that heart to not lose heart. Lord, I love you in Jesus' name. Amen. So church family, I'm praying for you today. Turn down the volume of the media. Turn up the truth of God's word, because he is truth. Don't lose heart. Keep focused on Jesus. I love you. And as always, in Christ, there is hope. God bless you guys. Have a great day.